morning. Well, it's Saturday the 18th of March. My name's Pete, and I've just departed Dartmouth, and I'm hopefully going to go to Scotland. At the moment, it's 3.8 knots of wind, southwesterly, so we're motoring along quite happily. We're in Z, which is my Westerly Storm, which I've owned for about 3 years now, and yeah, check in a bit later. So this is my third attempt at doing this. Back in 2018, I bought a new boat. It was a Rival 31 John Silver, and she was up in Rhyl. So what I hope to do, come out of Rhyl and go north and visit Scotland then, as I was sort of halfway there. But we had the beast from the east that year, so we ended up leaving in early June. Still cold then, but we didn't. We basically went over to Ireland and then came down to the Scillies. And then 2019, I bought Z, and she was in Lowestoft. So again, I thought to myself, well, I'll come out of Lowestoft and turn left, and bring her through the Caledonian Canal, something I've always wanted to do. But then, of course, that was COVID lockdown, and everything was getting delayed and delayed and delayed. And so here we are, 4 years later. So this is glorious at the moment. I mean, it's my first outing this year, and you don't want it to be too lumpy to start off with. Just get my sea legs back. It's about 5 knots from the southwest. It's forecast to come round later to the northwest. So what I'm trying to do is, so Plymouth is just ahead of me now, and I'm going to maintain this course, which is taking me towards the shore, and then as the northwesterly comes in, I should be able to get a bit of a better angle on her, a bit more like a beam reach. And I think when we get as far as Helford, I'll make a decision then. Hi. Following day, got as far as Falmouth. Decided to call it quits. It's now 2:45 PM and heading out. 16-17 knots from behind. So we're out of the Falmouth harbour. Start of the lizard.
More like it.
It's
cover rack over there. You see it? Lizard.
Over there. It's about 18, 19 knots. I've got two reefs in the main. They're doing anything between 5.9 and 6.5 knots in the water.
Axiom chart plotter,
which is linked to my other instruments, so you can see the AIS data at the bottom. It also gives me wind strength, obviously tide. It's also radar as well. And then, so my AIS and my radar also, I can beam those onto my iPad. So if I am trying to grab half an hour here and there, set the alarms up and sleep with the iPad, and hear if anything gets a bit too fruity.
So it's 10 to 2, and I'm rounding Land's End, called into Lamorna Cove, a couple of hours, have something to eat.
It's now nearly 4 a.m, getting a bit tired. This is where we are. So you can see, this is my iPad, and the information on the chart plotter is beamed down to this. So those are the AIS targets. I've also got radar on here, I've got radar alarms set. My AIS is a Vestal Marine Watchmate, which is brilliant. You can set the filters really well on that. So I've got a big loud rude awakening if anything comes too close. So I've decided, because of the shorter distance, and it probably makes it a little bit more sense, easy to get in as well, I'm heading for Milford Haven. Just to show the system works, I just got woken up. My guard zone on the radar was beeping, and I went up to have a look, and sure enough, there's a yacht. No AIS, quite a big yacht actually. Passed within, I don't know, a quarter of a mile of me.
Well, morning. It's now 11:36. I've eaten, I've had a little sleep. Well, I've had a few, three or four little sleeps. Don't feel too bad at all. 50 miles left to go to Milford, so halfway from when I rounded Land's End. Got just under 9 knots of wind, and I'm doing about 5.5 knots. So why am I sailing on my own? Well, there's the question. Well, A, I'm retired, or semi-retired, and most of my mates who I sail with, who come with me, they're still working. So they don't get the time off. My wife enjoys sailing, but not long passages, really. So she'll come and join me. When I get there, but I just enjoy the sort of the challenge of it, managing on your own, getting everything done yourself. You're the master of your own destiny. I think if you're with other people, family, wife, other people who aren't particularly, you know, keen sailors, you spend most of your time worrying about them. Are they all right? Are they feeling okay? Are they enjoying themselves? Are they bored? Whereas when you're on your own, you haven't got any of those worries. You've just got yourself to look after. So I wouldn't want to be on my own all the time, but it's just nice to be able to mix it. And I am looking forward to this trip. Should be a little bit of both, really, hopefully. So, you know, explore bits and pieces on my own and explore places with friends and family as well. Cracking sail. It's 6:15 PM. It's 15 knots, just sharper than a beam reach, and we're doing 7.5, making headed a little bit by the tide, so we did about 7 knots through the water, and we're 13 miles away from Milford Haven. The subject of this morning's sermon is on darkness. You don't realise this day and age, I think, with all this light pollution, about what a real dark night is like, what I did the other night, going into Lamona, but it was so black, there was next to no moon, that I just couldn't tell. I got totally disorientated. I couldn't tell whether I was heading towards cliffs, the open sea, or what. I mean, obviously, what I should have done was sorted myself out with a bearing before I left, but I didn't. And what saved me was that there was a ship on the horizon heading westward out of the channel. And I worked out that if I was just to point myself at him, that would keep me clear of all dangers, which is what I did. So that was the first subject on darkness. And then last night, coming into Milford Haven, I decided to anchor on the southerly edge of the harbour, in a place called Angle Bay, which was recommended for strong southerly winds. But it was torrential rain, howling wind, absolutely no light, or the only light that was there, which seemed to make it worse, was the oil refinery, which makes everywhere else appear absolutely black. So I've got my 3 million watt candle torch, which was useless because it just bounces off the rain. And I knew there was a lifeboat station, which should have clued me up that there might be a lifeboat at anchor. And sure enough, 10 feet, 15 feet in front of me appears a massive lifeboat, which I have to avoid round. And then I find myself that I'm amongst some small craft moorings and I'm seeing them at the last minute. So the second incident, I've navigated myself past the lifeboat and the other crafts, and I find myself a suitable spot, and I drop my lovely Rockner anchor, which I've been really impressed with. Not too bad. The wind wasn't too bad at the time, but I knew it was going to get up later, because I just used my my Navionics app on my phone to monitor the situation. So went to bed. I was really tired. I hardly got any sleep yesterday. Went to bed about 10 p.m. 1 o'clock. I woke up. Thought I'd check where I was, and I wasn't where I was supposed to be. So this is where I was originally. And this is where I ended up.
past the starboard hand marks, and I'm still dragging my anchor, and I'm trying to get that, and then it gets caught in the buoyage chain work. It'll be an absolute nightmare. But anyway, so I managed to get the anchor up before I got to the buoyage channel, reposition. It was this stage. It's gusting 25 knots. So I then reposition myself and drop lots of chain. In fact, probably most of my 50 meters, to be honest. But I had loads and loads of space. And she stuck like glue, and she has ever since. And I've just been up now, and we just had a gust of 30 knots.
A bit blurred. So we left Milford Haven at 4 p.m. What a horrible, I didn't have a chance to get the camera out, my GoPro's gone flat, but what a roller coaster coming out of there. They call it the washing machine, and you can see why. Absolutely mountainous seas, but long and smooth, but you'd bury the nose in and coming out. And so that was that. I then had to sort of come out pretty close to the wind to give myself some offing around Skoma and the other obstacles that lie to the north of the entrance. And here we are now. It's, oh God, I don't know what time it is today. It must be about 8 o'clock. And I'm going round St David's Head. Not been much to show you the last day or so, because I've been sailing at night. But just to recap, left Milford Haven on Monday at about 2 p.m. Very, very lumpy, windy night crossing from Milford Haven to Arklow. Gusting 30 knots, but wind behind me, so I did what I'm doing now and just had a Genoa up. She's solid as a rock, really, really impressed with her. And then just as it got windier, I wound a bit away, and backwards and forwards, but it was no issues at all, apart from got very tired. Got into Arklow at about 8:30. Nice little place, fantastic harbour master. Morning, Friday morning, about 7:30, leaving Belfast Bay, bound for Carlingford. 30 knots from basically the north. I'm getting myself out of the
traffic separation zone, leads into Dublin, and I'm sailing on a close reach, 6.4 knots. Great night last night, hope you enjoyed the music. I certainly did. A few pints of Guinness. So we left, it's about 10 o'clock, leaving Carlingford, very pretty place. And it's another miserable day, drizzly, head to wind. So I'm just gonna get back into pound, shillings and pence land. So I'm going about 25 miles up the coast to a place called Ardglass. Morning, Sunday, 2nd of April, 8:23. Left Ardglass, nice little place, probably the oldest harbour master in the world, must be waiting on his telegram from the King. He hobbled down to see me, told me I shouldn't have parked there because all the pontoons were up, but I'd phoned him earlier and said, where do you want to go? He goes, oh, there's plenty of space, just go anywhere. But anyway, I had to jump over a few loose boards. Not a problem. So anyway, now we're off to Campbelltown, so Scotland. It's 67 miles away, so I'm not going to be there until dark. There's a little marina there, but again, we've got 6 knots of wind, true wind. I'm motor sailing, doing about 6.5 through the water. The tide's about to change in our favour shortly, but Now, I'm hoping that somebody's going to be watching this video or these videos, because there's going to be more, you're lucky people, other than just my family and friends. There's going to be people watching who know an awful lot more than I do, and they'll be going, oh, what are we doing it like that? And there'll be other people who'll be scratching their heads saying, what is he on about? So, for those sort of people, I'll just give you a little whiz through about the boat and how I manage it on my own and the sort of the instruments I've got. You probably noticed that I don't really touch the tiller. You can't. I mean, especially times like today when you're just motor sailing, you just wouldn't be able to survive without one of these things. And it's a tiller pilot. So it steers the boat for me. It's connected to the navigation. Everything's connected together. So I can find a point on the map. For example, we're going to Campbelltown, and I put a waypoint outside Campbelltown, i.e. a dot to show me that's where I need to get to. And I can say go to, and this thing will steer me there. It won't steer me around land or around obstructions, but it'll basically do a straight line course to where I need to go. So obviously I still need to navigate. If, for example, I wanted to do all the steering, I would just put in waypoints around obstructions, so it would take me there. But this is the control panel for it. You see, I can plus 10 degrees or minus 10, which would take the boat to port. Sorry, take the boat to starboard, and minus 10, minus 1, which will bring the boat to port to the left. There's a standby and auto. So if I'm using it manually, I point the boat in the direction I want to go to, and just press auto. Nav instruments, very basic, quite simple. This one here is basically wind, speed and direction. So when the white arrow is pointing dead ahead or dead to the top, 12 o'clock, that means I am right close or heading into the wind. And like I'm off the wind, so if I was running with the wind directly behind me, that white arrow would be at 6 o'clock. So if I say I'm close hauled on this boat, it'd be between about 45 degrees, 50 degrees in the red or the green zone. A beam reach, which means the wind's on the side, would be 90 degrees. Broad reach, 120 degrees, and that's either side. And then the numbers in the middle, that's the wind strength. So you can either have it true or apparent. At the moment it's on apparent wind, so that means we're moving through the water towards the wind, and that is our speed. Now that's the wind speed, but obviously we're accelerating the wind speed because we're heading towards it. So if I press the true, it drops down to 3.5, which tells us what true wind speed. So if we were stopped, that would be the wind speed. We usually keep it on apparent. Boat knots here, and it will also give me trip. So 8 miles we've done so far today, and that's the sort of main log for the boat since it's been there. And there's various other things, temperatures and things. We'll always keep that on boat knots. Depth. 27.6 meters, and then this last display is attached to our to the GPS, so it tells us that we're sailing basically 42 degrees, and we're making 4 knots, 3.8 knots to the water. And the reason we've gone so slow is because my Genoa has backed, so I'll go and sort that out in a second. Yeah, difference between this here's speed through the water, and this is speed over the ground. So
So when, because we've been headed by the tide, that figure is less than that figure. When the tide comes in our favour shortly, this figure will be more. I should sort the sails out.
You'll know I always wear my life jacket. I never used to, naughty boy. But I do now, because my family would be devastated if anything ever happened to me. This yellow strap here, a couple of clips on it, is my safety line. So what I should do is when I go forward out the cockpit, or even clip on in the cockpit if the weather's particularly bad, it just basically tethers me to the boat. And there are lines, jack stays, which run the length of the boat, and I can clip onto those if I'm going forward. This thing here, this is my personal locator beacon. And basically, if I find myself going for an unplanned swim, I can activate this, and basically it's connected to the satellites, and it will say that I, because it's registered to me, am currently bobbing around in the Irish Sea, and would somebody please come and see if they can find me. So a handy little bit of kit.
Breakfast? Just course. This morning we're gonna have eggy bread, bacon. One fry pan. Butter. And that's that. Melt the butter and the gentle heat. Check we're not running into anybody. I wish those super tankers would just keep out of the bloody way. Add slightly frozen bacon. Wash down with some orange juice. Gotta keep the scurvy at bay. Always remember to put the lid back on the fridge. We're sort of toasting the bread, a little bit of butter in the pan with the bacon. Another little check. Just get out the way, will you? Take two newly ripened eggs, season. Sauce, bit of Tabasco. Thanks for watching.